So this is a very special case. You're looking inside the ICU of one of the major hospitals in our area. And all of you have been in ICUs. Is there anybody that has not been in an ICU? So just a few people. So you know what it's like. It's a very serious place. It's a locked door. You know, you just don't enter into an ICU and, you know, it's not like an open ward of the hospital. It's regulated because the people are so ill. And they're hanging on by a thread. And I have healed and done ministry in every kind of ICU there is. I've been in the cardiac intensive care, the medical ICUs, the trauma ICUs, the, you know, burn centers, critical care units of every kind. And so I'm used to ministering to people who are very compromised and again, just hanging on. And this man was typical. He would be typical of the patients that I shared with you when I first came here, where I've seen the Lord heal literally an army of quadriplegics, or quadriplegics who would otherwise be in a wheelchair for the rest of their life, unable to use their hands, having to depend on just, you know, using their mouth to, you know, give signals so that their wheelchair can move, to, you know, use a stylus. Be restored. And this man is a very dramatic case of this. He was actually in a trucking accident that occurred almost at midnight, and he fell down an embankment and broke every single bone of his neck, his cervical vertebrae, every one of them. So every one of you knows Christopher Reeves. It's hard to meet anybody who doesn't know who Christopher Reeves was. So Christopher Reeves, when he fractured his neck and became quadriplegic and never healed, was what we call a C1 fracture of the cervical vertebrae. He had the highest up fracture you can have. This man had the same thing, except every one of the other vertebrae in his neck was fractured. He was a total disaster. He was airshipped to his local hospital and operated on, as all of these patients are. So basically, he was just walking hardware in his neck. He was rods and, you know, screws and, you know, plates, and sometimes they'll put cages in. It's amazing what's done in the field of orthopedic surgery now and neurosurgery. But anyway, he was then airshipped down to the, by, you know, ambulance, helicopter down to the Bay Area. And what you're seeing in the ICU is a man with a huge smile on his face. Now, how many of you who've been in the ICUs have gone in there and seen a big, happy, grinning, smiling patient who had just come in there waving at you, who happens to be a quadriplegic? So this man, in 2 days, was already moving. And the next picture, you can see he's starting to move his leg. And he only was in the ICU for 4 days, and he totally freaked out his doctors. They told him he was healing too fast and that he should slow down because he wasn't supposed to be doing this. He's supposed to be in a wheelchair for the rest of his life. But God had other plans for him. And this man healed very quickly, and he left the hospital walking with a knee brace on. He happened to be a non-believer, and he came to Christ in the hospital. His marriage was repaired. He had a completely broken marriage and a broken body, and the Lord healed everything. He walked out, every part of him, body, mind, soul, healed.